This is a LabVIEW version 7 tutorial to help us get started quickly by performing exercise 1, which is to convert degrees C to degrees F. First, I always choose the drop down on new, and pressing drop down, I always just press, how about a blank VI? And first thing I do is expand the window left and right, tile it left and right, and what you'll see here is on the left is the front panel, and then on the right is the block diagram. When you click on the front panel, you get the numeric indicators. And if you press the up to the owning palette, which is probably where you started from, you get the controls, and you can do numeric controls or numeric indicators. These are the two we'll be using today. Over on the block diagram, when you click anywhere there, if I go back up to the home again, the functions, generally, we'll use the arithmetic compare here to do the arithmetic of adding and subtracting and dividing and so on like that. So just to begin with, the first thing we do back on the front panel is click on numeric controls. And the first one we'll choose is just a regular numeric control where you punch in a number. When you click on it, you can drag it up and drop it on the screen. And while you got the word numeric in black, I'll type in the word degrees C. And click anywhere in the screen that took it. So you can name that anything you want. And we could start with any number we wanted. We could start by going up, or we could say, we'll start with 50 degrees, let's say. Click somewhere on the screen. Actually, let's choose 25 degrees because we know the answer. 25, we'll say. I think the answer is 77 degrees Fahrenheit. We'll find out in a minute. Now, if you want to go back up to the owning palette, we could now choose numeric indicators, and this will be the output, and we'll again choose the numeric indicator and drop that, and we'll call that degrees F. Click somewhere. Now, automatically, while we did this, over on the block diagram, the output icons appeared. If we just ran a wire from degrees C right into degrees F, it would, whatever came up here would just appear over here. This is the connection line, but we won't do that. Instead, if I click on that and hit the delete key, let's do the arithmetic that's involved. And I'll move this context help out of the way. Actually, let me exit out. We'll get that back later. You'll see what that's for in a minute. So you grab the arithmetic compare, and when you click on that, we can choose... we choose numeric, and in here we can do additions, which we'll have to do. I'll drop that one up there, and we got to do multiplication too. I'll grab that one, drop that one up here, and I will go back to the owning palette. And now what we want to do is multiply whatever the degree C is by 1.8. So to multiply, we first of all connect up degree C using the connection tool, and then while we're here with the connection tool, if you right click, it gives you the chance to create a constant. This is the easiest way to enter a constant, and what we need there is 32, because that's what the equation states. And if you point to this, you can drag this down so you got a little more room. Now the addition, ooh, I typed in the wrong number. I'm sorry. We got to type in 1.8 is the multiplier. So you take degree C times 1.8, and then you add 32 to it, and you will have the correct degrees F. So to add, again, we use a connection tool. You right-click, create constant. This is where the 32 goes. And then we connect up the output to the degrees F. We are done. Now, since we've made no mistakes, all the lines look solid. You'll see soon when you make a mistake, there'll be a broken line, and we have to fix those. Now, back to the front panel. If we want to run this, we can, at this point, run it one time by pressing this, or run continuously by pressing this. Let's run it one time, and hopefully we'll get 77. Oh, my goodness, we got 77 for an answer. Or now, if we wanted to change this, we could change this number to anything we wanted. Let's say 100, and that should be 212, I think, and run it once, 212. Now, we can also change this. If you right-click on degrees F and you do a replace, We could replace that with a different type of indicator. And I like this thermometer bar down here. You grab that, and now it looks like a thermometer. Now, since we know degrees F are going up to 212, you want to double-click on the 100 and change that to, let's say, 300. And as you click outside of the area, it rescales it. And the degree C, let's right-click on that and replace that with a different numeric control. And you just, let's use the slider. Those are fun to play with. Or how about the pointer? Let's use the pointer. Okay, and you can grab this guy, oops, and bring it over so it's better on the screen. And degree C, let's double click on the 10, make that a higher number like 100. And it rescales automatically. And we can grab this slider and make it anywhere we want. Isn't that cool? Now the degrees thermometer, if you grab one of these guys, you can drag down here and make it a little bigger. And now when we run this, it shows it more in a graphical notation. And if we slide this, nothing happens because it's not running. But if we were running continuously, we could grab the slider and move it back and forth, and it responds directly. Okay, we're all done. We press the stop key to abort execution. We say file, save as. And we'll save it somewhere here. Let me find this good area here for this one. And I have something here. And you don't have to worry your heads about this one. You just store it somewhere. Probably in my documents is where you want it. End of story. Now, to dress up the program somewhat, we may want to put a caption under the input and the output. So if you double-click in the area, you could say this is the input. Degree C, and over here maybe we'll type in output result in degrees F, output result, out DVP result in degrees F. And the other thing you could do is answer the phone. So as I was about to say, if you go to the slider, right-click on it, and click description and tip, you can add a description that says something like, this is input. And as a tip, what you can say is, select a value using the slider. And if you say OK, and when we run this, you'll see what cool things happen. Let me move this up out of the way a little bit there. And if we run this now, when I go to point down here, I lied. What did I do here? If I go over here and point,